For aerospace engineering seniors, everything builds up to flight day. For their capstone projects, student teams spend hundreds of hours designing, redesigning, and constructing a rocket and an airplane that is capable of carrying the rocket for as many laps as possible inside the carrier dome.
Your imagination says that you can do one thing, the math says that you can do another thing, and then manufacturing and putting it all together says something completely different.
On flight day, most teams were still making adjustments right up until it was their turn to take off.
We wanted to like double, triple, quadruple check everything.
And then, the moment of truth.
That's the way you want it to be.
Yeah, I was really nervous.
When I saw it go level and then started to take off, I was felt a lot better. It's just such a satisfying feeling seeing probably 100 plus hours come together and actually fly.
There are no guarantees.
Very nervous, you don't know if it's gonna work or not. If you miss one thing, it's done.
But even after a crash, there's an opportunity to make adjustments and fly again. Luke Babich, Noah Cousineau, and Kevin Ryan's plane ran into trouble even before it left the ground.
As we were about to fly, one of our control horns, which makes the plane turn, it controls the aileron, was just completely disconnected.
On-site repairs, and then their chance.
To actually see something perform and that you built by yourself, it's a pretty rewarding design challenge.
It's a culmination of everything, all the hard work, all everything we've done the last 4 years, the late nights, the sweat, the tears, the blood, everything.
With repairs made and a second chance at flight, Anne-Marie Karras and James Grace put all of their aerospace engineering skills on the line.
It's gratifying to know that it could fly.